Hey guys, it's Bim here, and I'm sorry it's been a while. I had two exams this week, which were pretty terrifying, but I'm happy they're over with. And today, I will be doing a tea time plus whisper ramble video. So most of this video will be talking, and I'm sorry if you don't like that. So, I'll be pouring you a nice teacup of English breakfast tea, and it was made from loose leaves that I submerged in hot water, and pour you a cup. Here you go. My teacup. Delicious. I might as well start it doing. So I'm wondering, what's your guys' favorite type of tea? Mine has to be peppermint. I like it because it's good for digestion. And in general, it's refreshing to have when you first wake up. I notice it opens my throat and I feel so much better after the whole day. Whenever I'm sick, I tend to have peppermint tea. And before I go to sleep, I like chamomile. Something I like about both these teacups is they have a nice, like, gilded detail. And that makes them dishwasher safe, FYI. Also not microwavable. One time I had, like, a gilded teacup and I placed it in the microwave and saw sparks come off. It was terrifying. So, I'm just gonna I've been thinking a lot about, like, Mary Magdalene. If any of you guys know who she is, I'll just tell the story in case you don't. So, according to Christian texts, they don't name her explicitly, but they say that she stumbled into a room when Jesus and the apostles were having a discussion, and she was kind of like a harlot and was all covered and disgusting, but in her possession she had a bottle of perfume that was worth about a year's salary, and that perfume, she broke it open and started scrubbing Jesus' feet as some sort of admiration towards him. And at the time, that was sort of considered it was not appropriate. If you kind of think of Pulp Fiction with the sensual foot massage, I don't know why. I'm sorry. Anyway, that was not right, but Jesus didn't stop her and saw it as sort of endearing. Now, the reason I've been thinking about her a lot was I've sort of noticed that certain times we overlook people, and she's one of those, like, really overlooked people, I would say. And I wish those people would get more appreciation, kind of like the underdogs. Also, What also sparked that was I was looking at a piece by Michelangelo, and it was a sculpture of her, and she looked so haggard and rough. And I don't know why history has to remember her as some haggard harlot. I'm sorry. But what she did was viewed at the time as, I mean, not morally correct, but daring. And I'm gonna get off this quasi-religious tangent before some of you go crazy. So, I've also kind of been thinking a lot about this woman called Hereta Lacks. I recently read a book on the Helis Owls, and it had to do with her story. And she was a woman where they she had passed away from uterine cancer, and they scraped her cells. And since then, they've become, they were like the first cells to survive for long periods of time, to be cultured outside of the body. And they help create things like the polio vaccination, like test radiation and the effects it has on our cells, and a slew of so many other purposes. And I feel like she, again, is someone who we kind of glaze over in history and neglect to mention most of the time. And I just wish people like that would get more recognition. Get off my soapbox now. So I've kind of also been wondering, you guys, what type of videos you want me to produce. And I'm so sorry I've been neglecting this. I wish I could record every day, and that would be ideal. Class. I have class, and I have classwork, and sometimes I'm sitting there and I'm thinking, like, I'd much rather be recording or doing other things, but I don't want to squander the money I've spent on that. And I honestly start to brainstorm and I think of other ASMR ideas and ways to execute them, and I actually distract myself from the work I have at hand sometimes because my brain just rambles on into tangents. And I'm really sorry if I'm being jarring, or not relaxing or anything. I'm just kind of going off in my own brain. Would you like any more? Are you good? Okay. I'm happy you like the tea too. I love this teapot. It looks pretty oriental, and I got it at the Asian Food Center. I also got sushi there today, vegetarian sushi. It was pretty delicious. It was carrots, avocados, and cucumbers all in one mix. And I ate my 12 pieces of it, and that was my lunch right after working out. Sorry for snooping. Another thing that is on my mind just right now is I have the song Spanish Roots, A Spanish Leather, stuck in my head by Bob Dylan. And I've noticed that like through the folk movement, all the same songs are, all the Bob Dylan songs are covered by every another example of this is it's all over now, baby blue. And I noticed the Grateful Dead covered it, Joan Baez, and even Johnny Cash, so many other people. And the songs almost each time, they take on their own life, and like, depending on who is singing it, they kind of have a different meaning. Like, when I listen to Joan Baez's Spanish Boots, Spanish Leather, she's a lot more sincere and sweet to that lover, whereas Rob Dylan's kind of rough and edgy and not as mournful, you know what I'm saying? So I like the attitudes that these artists give their songs, even though they have the same exact lyrics, the meanings changed depending on who's singing it. And I don't know, I kind of find that beautiful. I see the same thing when other people read poetry. When I read my own, I already know the meaning at hand, and I will speak it out, and already know exactly where I want inflections or where to raise my voice. But when other people read it, it's like someone kissing your boyfriend, you know, and you feel like it's cheating on me. Because they just change the meaning so much depending on how they vocalize it and where they place their pauses and their chisuras and all that good stuff. So much meaning comes in from tone and just how we're speaking. And I feel like if people were to be more kind to others and speak more softly and sweetly and make more eye contact and be more sincere, I feel like we'd be a lot happier. When I'm out in public and a lot of times I try to make like eye contact with like a clerk or something, they just don't want to give me the time of day. They're just trying to move along and hustle and bustle. And I feel like we should all just take a moment to appreciate in this ASMR community the fact that we all connect with each other and we enjoy that kind of human interaction more along. By listening to someone softly speaking, it's kind of like a positive affirmation that we are one. I don't know if that's too far out there, but whatever. And I'm so sorry for being a little bit strange. It is about 1 a.m. and I didn't sleep much last night. So a few of you have asked me, how did I get my name, but I'm kind of like having that in a shroud of mystery, and one day I'll answer that question when the time calls for it. And that will be the day. It's actually kind of a long story. Kind of sad, but that's life. I'll get sad and strong. That's not cheery at all. I'm sorry. It didn't go down the right pipe. And I have to try and make a schedule to record more and more videos for you. And I'm going to try. I was thinking soon I was going to kind of record teaching basic phrases in German ASMR video, but I'm wondering if any of you guys would be actually interested in that. Because sometimes my ideas, I feel like people just aren't into them. I mean, I would enjoy watching that, but I don't know if you guys would, you know. It's all up to you. One of you asked me to do a chocolate collection video, and I bought chocolate covered strawberries, but I gave them to my brother to put away because he wanted a few, but he forgot and they got moldy. It was really sad, actually. So I think I'm just going to make them. When I was younger, I used to love to make them and put them in the freezer and then eat them. I don't know. But I try not to eat too much sweets or chocolate because I'm pretty big on working out and I feel like it's a lot to work off. But some days I don't care. It just depends on my mood, I suppose. I'm really sorry if this is not relaxing and that I'm really a bunch of tangents. I'm just letting my brain fall out like a projector projecting 1,000 stars on a screen and stuff. And that might be a little bit chaotic for some of you who are just trying to have a peaceful time. I'm gonna have my third cup of tea, and after I finish this, I will get to the video. I also have a question, you guys. I've been kind of contemplating what my Halloween costume should be. I was thinking about maybe being Cleopatra, and if all else fails, I'll be a cat. But if any of you guys have any creative suggestions, I would love to hear them down below. Because I'm really, really stumped what I shall be. My mom's being Leonard Cohen, which, God bless her. Actually, Leonard Cohen's one of my favorite musical artists. But it'll be interesting when she hands out all the candy to the little kids and they're like, "Who are you?" She'll be like, "I'm Leonard Cohen." And they'll never know who that is. Another overlooked person. Back to the other tangent. I was also thinking about doing for you guys kind of like a guided meditation. If you'd be into that, just tell me and I will for sure do it. Either just meditation or meditation plus yoga. I'm down to do both or do them separately. It just depends on what you guys want because I want my channel to cater towards you. To make you guys happy and make you relaxed and feel at peace and feel centered and all that good stuff. I just want it to be an all around positive and happy place for everyone. And if that entails me doing some yoga for you, I'm totally cool. So I have come to an end with my tea. As you can see, the leaves are at the bottom. And I hope you enjoyed your nice teacupful. And I will see you guys later and try to record some more videos later. Perhaps tomorrow. But just leave me any criticism, comments, or questions, and I will get back to you. And I promise to answer them and try and fit whatever needs you need. So if you're going to skip to this, I hope you have a wonderful rest. And if you're watching this for entertainment, I hope you were entertained slightly. And I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful time of day, whatever it is. And I miss all of you guys so much.